You're watching ViiniTV, the unofficial wine media representing coolest part of the continent, which is North.
My name is Ilkka Siren and this is Arto, the wine devil Koskelo, and Chance is the official wine duck of the show.
She's missing.
Fucking drunk yesterday, so she's not here, she's grounded.
So what are we gonna do today?
We're gonna do some wine and food matching, right?
Yeah. Well, we're not actually sommeliers. We have zero background when it comes to restaurant business, but let's give it a go.
Well, how hard can it be, actually? It's just pairing wine with food, no?
Yeah, wine world is filled with the myths, you know?
Exactly.
Stuff that basically always isn't true. So today we're going to try one of them. Matching chili with wine.
Let's cut to the crap and introduce the first...
Well, as a warm-up, we're going to do this one. Okay. Just to make sure you can handle the habanero.
Okay.
That is coming next.
Okay, and this is like your average basic chili.
Yeah, yeah, this shouldn't be...
And we eat this as a whole or...
Yeah, yeah.
Guys, nice and spicy.
Nice spicy sensation.
If somebody's wondering why we're doing this, please tell us because we have no idea.
Oh,
which is kind of has a nice kick to it.
This was a stupid idea, but
and you told me that this is nothing.
Yeah, that was nothing. This is habanero. I think it's one of the most hottest chili in the world. I think. I'm not that keen, you know, eating chili, but let's try it. So,
well, if you're not keen in eating chili,
so first
I'm definitely not.
Habanero, the first part is for pussies, and though the description fits us perfectly, we're pushing the envelope and going for the end part. And some people say that you should use rubber gloves when handling habanero. We're not going to do that. Biggest reason because Ilkka has used all of them while playing doctor by himself. So, are you ready?
Just a small slice.
Yeah, 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 of course. Please, take this off. Oh, this one's mine.
Jeez, I've done some stupid things in my life.
On the third, one, two. Nice and spicy.
This actually has a lot better taste than the first one. The first one was like really bitter.
Hey, this is actually really good. Let's give it another go. Whoa. So, please, help us.
So, what kind of feelings do you have like in your mouth right now?
It's nice peppery notes. Maybe some wine.
Maybe please. Some... It's a bit acidic as well.
Please,
hurry up.
Let's have sloppy seconds. On the go. There you go.
No.
Yep, there you go.
Serious? Jesus.
Yep. Thank you.
You want more?
Yep. Please be coming. This wine tastes like pain.
Is it true that it's supposed to get worse after a few minutes?
Yeah, a little bit.
I can't even taste it.
So not many Michelin star restaurants do this matchup because, well, it's rather painful. It's a bit harsh on your palate, but if you can appreciate good champagne, there should be no problem.
You told me some horror stories before that it can really mess up your stomach. So probably we're going to be trapping fireballs after this or something.
But I have to say the combination is not as bad as people say. It's actually really, 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 really tasty. You should definitely try this at home.
It's just 1 second of... 1 second of praying for you. Jesus!
Okay. Let's wrap this up. Thank you for watching, and I think the biggest victim of this whole experiment was the champagne. It really has zero taste after all of this fucking chili, but we tried it, and next I think we're gonna go and drink some water. See you next time. Bye.